Yeah, so we ended it here last Friday. We were just talking about some definitions for the different material constants. If you look at some real values for Young's modulus for rocks, so here's some different sandstones, limestones, and shales. You can see quite a variety. I don't know, you know, what to take away from this plot except to say that it's generally difficult to certainly just look at a material and be able to say what, you know, how stiff it is. So stiff is the word we would use to describe an elastic or Young's modulus. So, you know, particularly for a limestone or also, you know, it's very difficult to basically say because you have one limestone, one variety of limestone, because you have another variety of limestone, it's going to have a similar Young's modulus. It can vary pretty wildly in geomaterials. But, you know, steels, anybody know what the Young's modulus of steel is? In PSI, yeah. So I usually think like 200 GPA. 200 GPA is a good. And then, you know, for different variety of steels, that doesn't change a lot. It's, you know, it's roughly 200 GPA. But for rocks, it can vary quite widely. Not as much variability actually in Poisson ratio. I usually, well, at least there's a little bit in this limestone, but I usually think of a rock's Poisson ratio as somewhere around 0.2. But these are some real numbers. It's difficult. When I worked at Sandia, I used to go down and do some testing at White Sands Missile Range. And we would go down there and we would core the granite where we were going to do some testing. And we were looking at, so you guys have done unconfined compressive strength tests in your lab, right? And so we would core the granite and do unconfined compressive strength tests on it. And, you know, if you take a core from here, it'd have an unconfined compressive strength of like 4,000 PSI. And then you could take like 6 steps and take one from there and have 14,000 PSI. So it's difficult to do predictions. Although unconfined compressive strength is easily the most common. You got a question?
Are we supposed to be looking at these, like we take an average of the values, like with sandstone, or
look at nope. The lesson learned here is that you need to do a material experiment. If you have a given rock, I mean, if you have nothing, right, you can estimate something. But, I mean, I look at these and I say the lesson learned is if you actually want to do real calculations, you need to know what the real properties of the rock are, because it's not steel. It's not something that you can have a good guess at. Back to the point I was making about, you guys have done unconfined compressive strength tests on rock, and these are ubiquitously the most common experiments done on geomaterials. And a lot of times, this is the only test that'll be done, and therefore, it'll be given to you as if, well, here's the UCS, here's the unconfined compressive strength, as if you should know everything about the rock based on that. But it turns out that rocks in the situations that we use them, under confinement, right, they behave quite a bit differently than they do unconfined. And the unconfined compressive strength test is probably the least useful of any possible test you could do on the rock. But nevertheless, it is the most ubiquitous. You will see it. So, you know, that's why we do it in the lab. It's worth learning. But like I said, it's probably the least useful.